Hello guys, and welcome back to a new video here at Architects 3DP. Today I'm going to review a new 3D printer from JGAURORA that I have actually had laying around about 2 years.
If you remember, we have previously revealed the JG Maker Magic as the best 3D printer you could get for 134 euros at the time. This time we've got a new 3D printer from JGAURORA that is a bit more pricier, but a lot more quiet, robust, smooth, silent, and big.
As you may have seen at the beginning of the video,
this printer has the largest heated bed of all my 3D printers, with the exception of the Architects 3DP Mega that plays in another league.
I'm going to start with the unboxing before we jump to the assembly of this huge 3D printer, but we're gonna do that after I introduce you our sponsor for this video, PCBWay.
At PCBWay.com, right now you will find the PCBWay big sales, where you can get a total discount up to $435. Today I want to introduce you their sheet metal works that include laser cutting and bending, and you can choose in between a wide range of materials and thicknesses. We're going to use this service really soon for our Architects 3DP Mega, but as an introduction, I will tell you that you can choose in between aluminium, stainless steel, mild steel, copper, or PMMA. With each of these materials, you can choose a standard thickness or ask for your custom dimensions. After you upload your 3D files, you will be able to select more options, such as if your parts need to tap threads, insert, specific tolerances, special finishes, laser engraving, and more. Furthermore, you also have the option to ask for extra inspections, material certifications, and so on. Check out the PCBWay website through the link in the description. So we got at home this big and heavy box a few days ago that, as you can see, comes from JGAURORA and has some 3D printer graphics on it. I'm going to open it, but the box is that big that it barely fits on top of my desk. I can't even get the right angle to show you what's inside. If we have a look from the top, this is what you are going to find when you remove the first layer of protective foam on top. As you can see, a very good packaging with all the components correctly protected.
Now I'm going to start taking off the components out of the box to check out what's included.
And the first we can find is, as you can see, this 250 grams yellow PLA filament spool that will allow us to test the printer. Next we have a couple papers, a page with some warm tips, and the assembly instructions themselves, very simple in a single paper, that I hope will be good enough to show us how to assemble the printer. Finally, in this first floor of the box, we have the base of the printer that holds the Y-axis and all the electronic components and power supply inside. By the way, it is so heavy. Once I've put it away, I'm going to remove the second layer of protective foam to reveal the second floor of the box. Here, as you can see, we'll find some more components and accessories
that I'm going to reveal right now.
The first thing I'm going to take out is this piece right here that looks like a filament spool holder. As you can see, all metal, which is great. Next, we have this cardboard box that contains, as we can read, some parts of the 3D printer and the toolbox. I'm going to put it away and we'll check out later what's inside.
Once everything is removed, we'll only have what looks like the vertical axis of the 3D printer.
That includes the extruder, X and Y axis. So what I'm going to do now is to take it out of the box real quick and try to show it to you if I have enough space here, because it's really big. I'm going to first put the box away to make some room.
Now that we have cleaned up the desk, it's time to have a look to the components we just unboxed and proceed with the assembly of the JGAURORA A5S.
I'm going to start, by the way, with the accessories box you have seen before.
The first we're going to find is the power cable. In my case, I got the UK version.
But you can buy it with both options, UK or Europe version, depending on your needs. Next, we'll find this booklet that I'm obviously not going to read. And right next, we'll find this common USB SD card reader that we can find in a lot of printers, that has the USB Type-A plug in one of the sides, and an 8GB SanDisk SD card included. Next, we'll find what looks like a cable. Oh, it is a thermistor. I guess we'll be able to use it as a replacement in case of failure. Next, we'll also find a set of metallic clamps to clip the printing surface in place, and what looks like the necessary set of bolts and nuts to put everything together. We'll also find a spare 0.4mm nozzle underneath, a quite long USB cable to connect it to our PC. Also, we'll find a weird kind of cable cover that I don't really know what we'll use it for, and a set of Allen keys that we'll need to assemble our printer.
Alright, so before starting with the build, I'm going to bring to my desk
the base of the 3D printer we revealed at the beginning of the video and I have right here. What I'm going to do now is to remove all the plastics and protections JGAURORA installed to prevent components to break during the shipping. There is a brilliant sticker here on the side that says something very smart.
It is warning us about the blue tape on top of the print surface. And it basically says that the blue tape is included to avoid any possible damage on the nozzle or scrubbing the bed surface with the nozzle during the first bed leveling process. This is very smart, seriously, and I think all the manufacturers should do the same, because I have damaged some 3D printers before just making the first auto home before even leveling the bed. It's gonna be to bring the print bed all the way down, so that way it will be impossible for the nozzle to reach the print surface despite it's properly protected.
Alright, so now I'm going to remove the transparent film from the other side. And finally the white foam underneath the bed, which will allow it to move freely now. Next, the moment all of you are waiting for, the satisfying noise while peeling the front panel. I'm going to put the base away, since we'll need to remove all the protection from the vertical structure of the printer as well. I'm going to start from the film holding the extruder of the printer in the middle of the frame, next the film from the bottom, and now we'll need to remove this cardboard right here, for what we'll need to rotate the frame and remove it from the bottom just like so.
This is what we have got so far, guys.
Now the next step will be to put both parts together, for what we'll need to prepare the vertical structure in this position, and then drop in the base of the printer just like so. As you can see, it fits perfectly. When you fit both parts together, you have to look at this mark right here, that will need to be inserted aligned with the frame just like so. We haven't put any bolt in place yet, and the printer is already quite stable and rigid. The next step I'm going to do is, as you can imagine, to install all the bolts included using the provided Allen keys. To start, I'm going to pick up one of the small bolts, and I'm going to present it in place just like so. Don't put much pressure, since we'll do that once we have all of them inserted in place. Once done, we'll go to the second one, and once finished, we can now tighten the bolts. Now I'm going to connect the three cables right here, that as you can see are so easy to plug in. Next, we'll repeat the same process on the other side. So that's one bolt, the second one, and now we'll tighten both of them in place. Next, we'll need to rotate the printer just like so, to install the big bolts from the bottom of the base. So we'll insert all four of them in place using a washer this time, we'll insert all four of them, and then we'll tighten them as we always do. Here we go, now it's time to flip it in place. And the next component I'm going to install is the filament spool holder we saw at the beginning of the video, that goes right here. To install it in place, I'm going to screw the first bolt on top, then the middle one, and finally the bottom one. As always, once all of them in place, we'll tighten them. I'm going to unpack the filament spool to check out if it works, and as you can see, it does perfectly. Have a look at what's going on already, guys. It looks that we have finished the build of the printer, isn't it?
The JGAURORA A5S looks really cool, right? Okay, so once the printer is properly assembled, we're going to go to the back.
Here we're going to connect the power cable and we'll hit the power button. Back to the front of the printer, the screen will light up and we'll load the menu. Here, as you can see, we have the option to extrude filament, set the temperature, auto home settings, and so on. So we're gonna home the Z-axis first. I'm going to lower the print bed down a little bit, so we'll have more clearance, in order to make the bed leveling of the screen of the printer. First, we'll send it to the first point in the left bottom corner of the bed. Once here, we'll level it with a paper as we always do. Once done, we'll go to the second. Going back and forth till the first two points are properly leveled. Only then we'll jump to the third and fourth points. And after a couple minutes adjusting every single point, our printer will be properly leveled and ready to print. For the next step, we'll need to go to the filament settings and we'll hit load. The nozzle will go up and the temperature of the extruder will start rising up till the target temperature is hit. While it's heating, we'll insert the SD card in place. We'll also put the spool of filament in its support. And once the temperature of the nozzle is 200 degrees, we can introduce the filament into the extruder and the printer will start loading the filament until we start watching it coming out of the nozzle.
So once the filament is properly loaded, what we're going to do is to print one of the example files that normally the manufacturers include in the SD cards of the printers.
So back in the printer, we'll go to print and we'll select the file YF20-2018. Are you going to print the model? Yes. And the print bed and the extruder will start heating up to its target's temperature, as you can see here. While printing, we can go to Option and Stop, Pause, or go to More and adjust the temperature, the fan speed, or the print speed on the go.
So we'll just wait till the temperature is ready.
And once there, the printer will start moving, as you can see. I'm going to let you with a short time-lapse of our first print.
Alright guys, so the truth is that it's been almost 2 years since JGAURORA sent over this great 3D printer and I recorded the unboxing and assembly. 2 years later, the printer is still in good shape, maybe with a couple of fixes I made due to the use I made out of it, but it is still working at 100%. As you can see, it has helped me a lot in big production prints due to its big print bed size. I can almost double the number of figurines I can fit in a single print if we compare it with my other 3D printers. Okay, so now I guess we have reached the end of this video. Remember that you will find the link to buy the 3D printer down in the description. To finish, I want to ask you to hit the like button and leave a comment down below if you really enjoyed the video. And also give a special shout out to our Patreon supporters for making our channel possible. Please consider joining them to support the channel as well. And as always, see you in the next video.